हेलो फ्रेंड्स फ्रेंड्स टुडे आई हैव कम विथ द एप्रिसिएशन ऑफ द इंचकेप रॉक। वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड दिस पोयम एंड आई होप यू ऑल हैव वॉच्ड दैट वीडियो। सो द एप्रिसिएशन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एप्रिसिएशन। व्हाट इज एप्रिसिएशन? एप्रिसिएशन मीन्स टू फाइंड आउट द क्वालिटीज ऑफ अ पोयम and to discuss those points, which are those points which will reveal the good qualities of the poem. The points for appreciations to reveal the good qualities are: we have first title, then we have poem, we should talk about poem, then we should talk about poet, theme, style, special features, moral of the poem or message of the poem. If moral and message, these things are not there, we should write the significance of the poem, and finally we should write our opinion about the poem. So the first important point is title. What is title? Title is a key, and that key helps us to understand the meaning of the poem, or it also gives us a view about the summary of the poem. Now in this poem, you know the title, but what it signifies? Yes. When we discuss about the title, we should discuss how it is significant or what does it signify. The title Inchcape Rock is significant in many ways. So which are those ways? It is a symbol of goodness. This is the most important point. We saw the good qualities of somebody in the poem. So the title is nothing but the symbol of goodness. Apart from that, we should not forget what does it represent. It also represents the virtue and an action of goodness. Now what is virtue? Virtue means the good quality. There are certain things in the poem which tell us that something, it is related to behavior, something it is related to thought process, and finally it reveals whether it is virtue or vice. So the name of the title, that is Inchcape Rock, represents virtue and an act of goodness. This is also one of the very important thing that the poem represents, an act of goodness. We have seen in the poem, somebody does something that was good for the other. Now this is title. Now let us talk about the poem. What can we talk about the poem? We can talk about the form of the poem. We can discuss exactly what is given in the poem. And is there any effect over us about the poem that we should discuss? Now let us see. The poem. The poem Inchcape Rock is long narrative poem. The first important point that we are discussing about the poem, that it is long poem, and at the same time it is narrative poem. What is narrative? What is narration? Narration is to tell the story. Yes, this poem tells us the story. It is written in the form of ballad. This is very important point that we should never forget to discuss about this point. What is ballad? Ballad is a kind of poem that appreciates the quality of great heroes. As in Maharashtra, we have number of ballads written on Shivaji Maharaj. In Marathi, we call it Povada. So this poem is also nothing but a ballad. Now, what is given in the poem? This poem depicts the story of an Inchcape Bell. Yes, there is one bell which is there on the Inchcape Rock, and therefore it is called as Inchcape Bell. And this story depicts, or this poem depicts, the story of the same bell. And when we read the poem reveals a story that moves very smoothly, and it gives one incident to another. Very, very smoothly, very easily, we get these different incidents, and these incidents creates our interest in the poem, and we continue to read this poem. It creates vivid pictures in the mind of the reader. The poet has described each and everything so nicely that the poem creates vivid pictures in the minds of the readers. So this is what all about poem that we have discussed. Now we will discuss about the poet who has written the poem. Now the name is very famous, name is well known, because this poet belonged to the Romantic school of poetry. Romantic school of poetry means Romantic period. And we know William Wordsworth, S.T. Coleridge, these were the well-known poets who belong to this particular age. So Robert Southey is the name of the poet of this poem, and is famous, why? Because he belonged to the Romantic school of poetry, means Romantic age. He was not famous because he belonged to Romantic school of poetry, but because he was really a very great poet that we already experienced while learning this poem. He is famous for writing narrative poems. So the example is there in front of us. He has written so beautiful poem, and it is narrative because it tells us a story. Now the present poem is also dramatic or narrative poem that gives the message to be good. So the present poem that we are studying, or we have already studied, this poem is what? It is dramatic because, yes, there are dramatic elements in the poem. It is narrative because it tells the story. And finally, it gives the message that we should be good, then only good will happen to us. Now the next point that we will discuss, the point is theme. This is important point. Any poem deals with certain subject, and that subject matter is nothing but theme. We also call it central idea of the poem. So what is the central idea of the poem? So before that, what type of theme the poem has? So this poem has moral theme. What is moral? What is the meaning of moral theme? It means that this poem teaches us something. Now the poem that teaches something is called as didactic or didactic poem. So didactic is the pronunciation of British English, and didactic is the pronunciation of American English. So the poem that teaches us something, that poem is called as didactic poem. This is also a kind of poetry. As we have ballad, in the same way, this is the subtype. As it teaches us something, therefore it is called as didactic poem. The poem depicts the poetic justice. Now this is very important concept. I request you to understand this concept properly. Poetic justice means what? In a play or in a drama or in a story, if somebody is good and that good person behaves good, so what happens? That person gets the reward. If the person is good, the good person gets rewards. And if the person is bad, he gets punishment. If it happens, it means that the poetic justice is followed by the writer or the poet. So in the present poet, present poem, the poetic justice is followed. Why it is followed? Because we have studied this poem, and we studied that the person who was bad he got the punishment for his bad deed. Therefore, the poem follows the rule of poetic justice. This poetic justice, it is revealed here that crime gets its own punishment. Crime here represents the criminal. The person who commits a crime gets its punishment, and therefore poetic justice has been followed. So what happens? The rover cuts the bell to annoy the good abbot of Aberbrothok. Abbot of Aberbrothok had placed that bell on the Inchcape Rock, and rover was not happy for him because people blessed him. So rover wanted to annoy abbot, and for that what he did? He cuts the bell, and he creates problems for other helpless sailors who were taking help of that bell to save their lives. But what happens? But in the end, he falls into his own laid trap and regrets helplessly. A time comes when he himself needs that bell, but bell was not there because he had already cut that, and he laments over that. But at that time, the time was not there, it was very late, and he regrets because he had fallen himself in the trap that was laid by himself. So this is the theme of the poem. The next important point is style. This poem is long poem of 17 quatrains. Quatrains means a stanza of 4 lines. So how many stanzas are there of 4 lines in this poem? 17 lines. So what is style? Style is nothing but something that is related to language, something that is related to the composition of poetry. So the composition of poetry is, it has 17 quatrains. First 2 lines of every stanza rhymes with each other. So what is the rhyming scheme? A-A. First and second, A-A. Third line with fourth. Therefore, it is B-B. A-A-B-B is the rhyme scheme. So which are the figures of speech which are prominent in the poem? The first one is alliteration. The second one is personification. So these are the significant figures of speech. The example of alliteration is, the ship was as still as she could be. Alliteration means the initial sound of the word repeats. Here we have so, so, so. Therefore, the figure of speech of this line is alliteration. And example of personification is, her keel was steady in the ocean. Now, her is the pronunciation that belongs to the human being. Here it is used for the ship, and therefore the figure of speech is personification. Overall, language is very easy to understand, and therefore the poem is not so difficult. The next important point is special features. The poet has used descriptive and narrative techniques. How we can say that there is a descriptive technique? Yes. There is a description of environment, there is a description of sea, there is a description of the characters of the story. Therefore, we can say that the poet has used the descriptive technique. At the same time, one more important technique that poet has used, that is narrative. How can we say that? Because almost in every stanza, there are some events that take place, and the poet tells about it. It means that he is narrating the story, what is happening over there. So these are the two important techniques that poet has used, and for what he has used it? To enhance the effect of the poem. The poem provides verbal image of calm atmosphere, verbal image. And what image he has used? Of the calm atmosphere. The atmosphere was very, very calm in the beginning of the poem that we had studied, At the same time, there is one more image of Inchcape Rock, and that Inchcape Rock is the symbol of goodness. Why here we have written verbal? Because with the help of words, the poet describes the atmosphere, and that description is so apt, so beautiful. The whole incident or atmosphere appears in front of our mind, and we see the visual qualities of that description. So the poem also provides the supernatural elements. I have discussed in the poem. So you once again go through the poem and understand what supernatural element is. And those supernatural elements are about darkness and drifting of the ship. Alright. So this is the special feature. Once again, I will read it for you. The poet has used descriptive and narrative techniques to enhance the effect of the poem. The poem provides verbal image of the calm atmosphere and the Inchcape Rock as the symbol of goodness. It also provides the supernatural element of darkness and the drifting of the ship. Alright. The next important point, that is moral of the poem. Does this poem teach something? Of course, yes. The moral of the poem is, it is given in the beginning of the poem. Some important proverbs are given. So here I have taken two proverbs. The first one is, as you sow. Okay, I have forgotten here. As you sow. The word sow I will write here. As you sow, so shall you reap. As you sow, so shall you reap. This is the moral of the story, moral of the poem. One more proverb here I have taken. Evil digs a bit for others, but falls into the same. मतलब, जो दूसरे के लिए गड्ढा खोदता है, वही उसमें गिरता है. और as you sow, so shall you reap. इसका मतलब जैसी करनी, वैसी भरनी. So these are the two important morals of the poem. How it happens? The rower, the Ralph the rower, we know it. We know him. He cuts the bell and he falls into his own lead trap. यहाँ पर वो bell cut कर देता है और finally उसी bell की ज़रूरत पड़ती है और उसी Inchcape Rock से उसका शिप जाकर टकराता है. बेल का आवाज़ सुनाई नहीं देता, इसलिए वहाँ पर उसकी मृत्यु हो जाती है. बट वेन ही कम्स टू नो दैट ही शिप गॉट डैश टू दैट रिफ, ही रिग्रेट्स फॉर हिमसेल्फ. बट इट वॉज सो लेट दैट ही कुड नॉट हेल्प हिमसेल्फ. सो ही रिग्रेट्स फॉर हिज ओन एक्शन, बट इट बिकम्स लेट. So nothing he could do afterwards. The last point is opinion. I think poem serves its purpose and motivates us to think that our ill actions can turn against ourselves. So what is the purpose of the poem? I think the poem serves its purpose. So what is the purpose? To motivate us to be good. The poem motivates us to be good. And the poem tells us that our ill actions, hamari buri kartute, can turn against ourselves. Wo hamare liye hi ghatak ho jati hai. And we can fall in our own lead trap. Aur hum apne hi banaye huye gadde mein gir sakte hain. So I really enjoyed the poem. The poem was beautiful. Yes, every reader must enjoy it. And specially, what is the thing that we should enjoy? Specially the way it is narrated. Yes, the poem, the poet has narrated whole incident so beautifully that we liked it very much. Alright, thank you. Channel ko subscribe nahi kiya hoga to jaldi se jaldi subscribe karo aur apne doston tak ye link share karo aur comment karo. Theek hai? Thank you.